when it comes to AI in the classroom, there are at least two ways you can think about how AI is integrated here at Columbia Business School. I mean, one way is bringing it directly into exercises we do, into how do I use AI to address different questions that are being posed in class to help us, for example, with data analysis, something I do with my classes. A second way in which AI is very much incorporated in many of our classes here at Columbia Business School is what are the implications of AI for the world of business? How would AI change the world of finance? How would it change the world of marketing, the world of healthcare or climate? And discussing the role of AI in these businesses and how our students should be prepare themselves to a world in which AI will be very much embedded in all of these industries.
One of my key aims when I teach AI in the classroom is to help students understand that these models are not as scary as they seem. Even though they seem magical, even though they seem like there's some sort of gremlin inside your computer that's magically responding to what you're asking, at the end of the day, it's just a whole bunch of very simple operations that get combined in very sort of complex ways to produce the answer that you see. So if I can, I'll build a much simpler version of that AI for them, sometimes even using something like Microsoft Excel. We actually have a whole neural network in Microsoft Excel that we use in one of my classes to show the students that in reality, all that's going on in the background is operations you're probably familiar with, additions, multiplications, etc., and to show them how when you combine lots and lots and lots of those operations at scale, you suddenly get the magic emerging that we see when we actually see AI in practice.
I've used AI to have folks using text-to-image generative AI illustrate what their inner critic look like if you could see it. And I find that it's a great way to negotiate with our mindsets and to get them to a place that might be more conducive to reaching our goals.
I co-teach a course with Professor Kamel Jadidi called Market Intelligence, the Art and the Science. And we use AI, typically generative AI, throughout the course. So out of 24 sessions, we would probably have about 22 of the sessions that somehow either mention AI or demonstrate the use of AI. Students are also tasked with using AI in mainly their major market research projects for the course, where they work with real entrepreneurial companies.
I think CBS is the best place to study AI because we have cracked the code to teaching our students about AI at a level that is not super high level like a TED Talk or a New York Times article, and also not super deep like an engineering class. We teach them how these models work and how to deeply understand what goes on behind them without necessarily needing all the math and the calculus and all that kind of stuff. And I've certainly found, even in the short space of time that AI has been sort of so prominent in industry, that it puts our students in an absolutely fantastic position to be part of the implementation of these algorithms in the workplace and to really be able to contribute and work with more technical counterparts. We've been teaching data analytics and early forms of AI for at least 10 years, if not longer, at CBS. And so during that time, I think we've really mastered this ability to teach MBAs the technical aspects of AI only as far as they need them, and to make them sort of successful in working with engineering teams who are going to be implementing them.
Historically, CBS invested early on in, I would say, transforming the curriculum to prepare the students for this, I would say, what one could call a digital future that was unfolding. And I would see AI as one of the pieces of this digital future. CBS is also, you know, a place where you have, you know, leading figures, leading educators, and leading researchers in the space. You have people who look at essentially the techniques associated with AI, but also people who look at how these tools are deployed, or potentially even more importantly, should be deployed in industry, and also how these tools are affecting different industries.
I think in this environment, an entrepreneurial spirit is really valued and really supported. And I know that I have felt encouraged to take small calculated risks when I thought that it could be of benefit to students' learning, to students' growth, to their development, to my own development and learning as an educator. And so I think it's an exciting place to sort of experiment and learn with this new technology.
We really have top faculty in each one of the areas within business, and we have top faculty dealing with AI algorithm, whether it's how Spotify uses it, how pricing in Amazon or Uber, how inventory, for example, at Amazon is being done. We have faculty dealing more with applications of AI, whether it is in areas like marketing or AI in retail, AI in healthcare, AI in climate. And finally, we have a set of faculty who are thinking about the future of work. How would the future of work look like in a world in which all of us are likely to be using AI? We are advancing very fast in terms of both creating elective courses around topics like generative AI, but really bringing it into almost everything we do in the classroom, into the core classes and other classes.
What we understand as professors, and the business school certainly understands, is that it would be a disservice to students to not equip them fully in the use of artificial intelligence so that when they enter or re-enter the job market, they're really well equipped to use it.
I mean, AI, to be honest, is not new. I mean, AI has been shaping the world of business quite a bit. I mean, if you think about the area I'm coming from, marketing, online advertising have been pretty much influenced by AI for a while. But indeed, the new world of generative AI is creating a huge change in the world. And I'm much more bullish than bearish about it in the sense of, is it more of a replacement of jobs or is it more of an enhancement of jobs? I actually believe it's much more an enhancer of jobs, in the sense that what AI is likely to do is to take from us some of the mundane tasks, leaving us with more of the interesting things, with the decision making, with synthesis of information.
AI is going to allow us to just take this massive scale of data in the real world and immediately convert it to a form that it's digitally accessible, that it's accessible to models. And so I think that narrowing of that gap, that ability to effectively blur the difference between the real world and then the stuff that we can do in a digital sphere is going to be incredibly impactful to business, incredibly challenging too, and I think we're at the very sort of birth of figuring out exactly what impact this is going to have, but that's something I'm very excited about.
I'm hoping that AI will shape the future of business for the better, but I know that it's not going to happen on its own. It's going to really require thoughtful leadership, intentional leadership, to make sure that we are using this as a vehicle for the better, to help more folks thrive, to free up time and resources so that they're able to make their dreams a reality. But I think it will require us to reconnect with our values and our commitments within our community to make that happen.
AI is going to significantly enhance human productivity in a variety of areas. It's also going to potentially decrease barriers to entry in a variety of industries as well. In some sense, the advent, for example, of chatbots had put back at the forefront the art of asking good questions. And in a way, through these systems that are, I would say, democratizing access to a variety of resources, we are also putting back in the center stage that art of asking good questions and good follow-up questions to get the best possible answers.
AI is permeating every aspect of business now. In marketing research, which is my wheelhouse, it's used for everything from scoping out the size of a market, key competitors, market segments, that is the specific customers that you might want to reach. AI is also really good for designing market research projects, defining problems, developing questionnaires, developing interview guides, analyzing data, creating marketing tactics and strategies, and even coming up with new product ideas.
AI, and in particular generative AI, will make us more productive. It will decrease inequality by leveling the playing field. It will help us improve work-life balance by allowing us to do more in less time. But it could also have very negative effects. It could also increase inequality by only allowing a few people to keep their jobs, by perhaps reducing job opportunities for many people. And that will be, again, determined by the actions of our leaders of tomorrow. And I think that's why it's so important to have our students think about AI, because they will be the ones shaping the impact of AI on society and business.